LCL and groupage is the same thing, okay? But the key to understanding it is it's the same service provided by different people. Can I make this point? LCL services are provided by who? Who provides LCL services? Shipping lines, i.e. your SAF Marine, your Maersk, your MSC, etc., etc. You get an LCL service from a shipping line. Groupage service is the same service, but it's provided by agents. That's it. It's the same thing, but provided by agents.
So you pay one for this, one for that, one.
No. Still. Okay, can we come to that?
Yeah.
Let's explain it right now. If we were to take this diagram and now just change it for groupage, we'll take this depot away and we'll replace it with the agent's warehouse. Because most groupage operators have their own warehouse. They say, the groupage operator says to you, exporters, bring your stuff to me. He consolidates it and he puts it into an FCL. And now he phones the shipping line. And what does he book with the shipping line?
Container.
Full container, not so. So he pays the box rate.
But you're paying him the other rate.
You're paying him the other rate. So he's making the profit now instead of the shipping line. You see that? So he books a full container with the shipping line. And he charges these guys per ton. Okay. He sends the goods not to a foreign depot, but to his associate agent on the other side. They've got reciprocal agreements. They load and they unload for each other. Okay. So now the question is, how many bills of lading does the shipping line issue now?
Only one, because it's going to the agent.
Yeah. As far as the shipping line is concerned, this is an FCL. Shipped by this agent to this agent. So the shipping line now only issues one. So LCL, we have this situation. There's the container, three people's cargo in it. Three separate sets of bills of lading, not so. Now you speak about groupage. You've got the same container, three cargo, but only one bill of lading. Does the shipping line know that there's three people's cargo in it? They know. Because if it's coming from through tainers or group container, I'm just giving you, they know these guys are groupage. And they know this consolidated. Are they interested?
No, they're not interested.
They're not carrying the risk. They're saying we're shipping a full container. Mm-hmm. Okay. So they issue a single bill of lading.
If anything goes wrong, the agent's liable.
Yeah, of course.
Is there any advantage to using an agent?
I'll come to that now. Can I just finish explaining the mechanics of this? Okay. Now, here's the problem. Each of these exporters need a bill of lading, not so. What's the agent do now? What does the agent do now? It's easy. The agent does his own bills of lading. Okay, he does his own bills of lading. So now, these bills of lading were whose bills of lading? On whose letterhead did they appear? The shipping line, not so. These bills of lading, they're on the agent's letterhead, not so. And these bills of lading have got a special name. They are called house bills. So when you do groupage, you have house bills. Issued by the agent. When you do LCL, you do not have house bills.